Nithyanandam Paramasukadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gagana Sadrisham Tattvamasyati Lakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshi Bhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Nithyanandam, I welcome all the viewers, all the Adikailayavasis and everybody else to this Shakthi Avishkarana. The offering of the extraordinary space of oneness with Paramashiva in form as His Divine Holiness Paramahamsa Nithyananda Swamiji being expressed as extraordinary Shaktis, powers. In today's Shakthi Avishkarana, we are going to be sharing with you all, or rather, experientially demonstrating to you all what the right knowledge is. Today Swamiji was very beautifully sharing in the satsang that all our cognitions are our basic understandings about life. The best and the ultimate cognitions starts manifesting as powers in us. Like how we believe that if any theory in science, when it is proved practical, it is believed. Same way Swamiji beautifully says that Hinduism is not a religion, not a philosophy, but a lifestyle that can be experienced as a science and that can be replicated to anybody. All our cognitions, all our understandings about life are so limited with what we think as ourselves. Until and unless we experience that breakthrough of experiencing something beyond what we understand as our normal cognitions in life, the normal conditionings that we experience in our life. Swamiji very beautifully says that this is the very purpose that Paramashiva himself has come down in Swamiji's form to remind all of us and to make all of us understand what this breakthrough is. It is not, when I say breakthrough, it is not something that is different than normal of what we experience, but it is experiencing what we call as the impossible. And these extraordinary Shaktis are not just to the person who's expressing it, but just by witnessing, just by sitting and going through of what is being demonstrated itself causes a very beautiful shift in the space, in the thinking current, in anybody who witnesses it. And today, I have one of the Balasins from Nithyananda Gurukul, Kanchan, with me on the stage, who is going to be demonstrating, expressing her space of oneness, manifesting as Shaktis. So I'm going to be calling upon one of the volunteer onto the stage. Nithyanandamma, so can I request you to introduce yourself, where you are from and how long you've been in the Adinam and when you met Swamiji?
Nithyananda, my name is Ilona and I'm from Estonia. I met Swamiji through YouTube, as many people are meeting him. And since then I had a lot of clicks. And the reason I'm here is I have been answered on many of my questions. And I have been here a month and I'm first Estonian Adinavasi.
All right. So having met Swamiji recently, you have chosen to live with him, around him, as his own Adikalayavasi. So now, are you ready to see how Kanchan is going to be expressing the extraordinary power of third eye?
Yes.
So what I'm going to be doing now is, I have these surgical eye patches with me, which I'll be giving to you. You can check and verify that they are fresh and new. And you can show it to the camera to reassure all our viewers that we are using the fresh ones. Yes. So now I request you to put the eye patches on Kanchan's eyes, ensuring that all the gaps are completely covered and it's completely pasted around her eyes. So Ma Kanchan, are you comfortable? Yes. So now, Ma, I request you to share in the mic. If you are confident and sure that there's absolutely no gap and it's completely pasted around her eyes.
Yes, it's completely covered.
So I'll now be showing it in the camera. I request the camera to show a close-up. That her eyes are completely pasted and there's no gap. Now, I'm going to be giving you a clipboard with few plain A4 sheets and a marker, and I request you to write any words that you want in English. So, Ma Kanchan will be connecting to Swamiji and reading it through a third eye. Yes. So before that, I just want to ensure that the hair that is stuck with the eye patch is also moved. So the eye patch is completely stuck to her skin. Yes. Yes. So now I request you to hand over the clipboard to her. So she'll be able to start reading whatever you have written. Yes, you can give it to her. Spiritually, you all can see that within few seconds she was exactly able to read as she wrote in the clipboard. I request you to actually write a sentence in English. So she'll be able to read out the entire sentence, and something that is not related that we'll not be able to easily guess, maybe a house address or something like that. So as she's writing, I'll now be sharing with you all the source of this science of third eye awakening, where Paramashiva in his first incarnation beautifully explains the science to Parashakti, which I'll now be chanting to all of you. It is beautifully explained in the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, in the 34th Sutra and the 11th Dharana, which I'll be chanting to you all now.
Kapalantarmanonasya tishtan milita lochana kramena manasodardhyat lakshaye lakshamuttamam. Kapalantarmanonasya tishtan milita lochana kramena manasodardhyat lakshaye lakshamuttamam.
Paramashiva beautifully explains the science that by fixing the mind on the inner space within the crown center and sitting stably without any movement, having the eyes closed, in succession by that stability of the mind and inner space, with the power of third eye, one directly sees the ultimate goal, the lakshyam, by having the vision beyond the sight that reveals any object or place attaining the space of oneness with the source Paramashiva. What all of us are seeing now is this very science being given to us as a Sakshi Pramana, the experience of the source knowledge. Now, Uma, are you ready with a sentence? You ready? So I request you to give it to Ma Kanchan, and she'll be connecting to Swamiji and reading as what you've written.
I love Indian food.
Y'all can see that she was exactly able to read out as Ma had written. Thank you, Kanchan. But one thing that I would really like the viewers to know is one part of it where we connect to Swamiji and read, where we experience the space of oneness, always happens as a natural flow of manifesting Shaktis. But what I would like the viewers to really hear is sitting here and just witnessing how she was able to read and writing and giving. Personally, what was your experience of going through this whole thing?
It was very cool. I want to have that Shakti too. Very, very fast answers straight away. Yes, inspiring.
Swamiji very beautifully explains that power manifestation is not just limited to one person, just the person who's doing it, but the joy that starts happening in the person who's manifesting. When it is shared, when it is manifested with people, and when that joy is being experienced by people around, that is a beautiful experience of Shaktini Pada that happens. The entanglement that happens, where everyone around starts experiencing the same space of oneness. So I thank both the volunteer and the Balasanth to have come here to share the stage with us, to express how the space of oneness starts manifesting as extraordinary powers. And we would like to offer our heartfelt gratitude to Paramashiva, who has happened as Paramahamsa Nithyananda Swami in all of our life, to give us the experience of the state, space and the powers of Paramashiva.